Welcome to Connie Martinson Talks Books. I have just finished reading one of the best books about Hollywood. It is an autobiography. It's written by my guest, Carrie White. The book is called Upper Cut. It is Highlights of My Hollywood Life. It's published by Atria Press. Welcome, Carrie.
Thank you so much for having me here and allowing me the opportunity to share Uppercut to the world.
This book is, I mean, what can I say? You had a life from Mommy Dearest to I'll Cry Tomorrow. Mm. Brought up, your father leaves your mother and you, and your mother is an alcoholic who also paints in animation.
Yes.
She marries or gets involved again with a man who is the scum of the earth, who molest you.
Yes.
And it's only because you mention it to a good friend and you say, don't tell anyone, promise me you won't. And she says to you, the best advice, you must tell the priest. Mm. You must tell the minister. Which in your youth, how old were you, 8?
Yes.
You tell him and he has the police come and that man is removed.
Mm-hmm.
How many years did you live worrying whether he was going to come back to beat you?
Till I was late in my teenage years, I think, because the most punishment for child molesting and child abuse, he used to beat me with a hairbrush, which is odd that I end up being a hairdresser, but living well is the best revenge. I could feel protected for 6 months. That was the maximum sentence. So, and he was never mentioned. I never knew what happened to him, and I never did see him again. I wish I would have known he was never coming back.
You go, your mother moves you, well, in between. They're wonderful people, and you do have a picture of that woman who, with her husband, really protected you. And it's in this picture. Mrs. Albrecht.
Oh, well, actually, Connie, sweetheart, that is Peggy Albrecht, who ran the recovery house that I came through. I don't have a photograph of Babe and Virginia, who were my foster parents and took care of me and the strays in the neighborhood of Pacoima, which was a very rough gang area. But like I say, it was safer for me to be in gangs than go home with this child molesting child-beating man.
Off to Hollywood and Hollywood High School.
Yes, my
there
mother returned.
Yeah, living the sort of the MGM Andy Hardy life and joining, what was it, the Deltas?
The Deltas.
As a kid whose mother isn't really there for her, who doesn't have the funds that, say, a Dana Andrews daughter does.
Exactly.
And there's nothing worse than being a hanger-on.
Well, and also just not knowing, you know. I say how the only thing I knew about clothes is that you would shoplift. I didn't know they had labels in them, and there was such a thing as guy's tax, or, you know, there was the status.
Even at your graduation, your mother doesn't show up.
I know, so sad for her. You know, it was sad for me, but it was really sad for her. I understand that now. I didn't at the time. She just couldn't show up. Not for me, not for her life. It was alcoholism.
Was the drug of choice.
Yeah.
And in your case, you now discover, hey, everyone's going off to college. Where am I going?
Well, like I say, I left algebra because they wouldn't tell me what the X and the Y was. When somebody asked me, what'd you get on your GED, I said, I don't think I took GED.
Then starts, you go to the Lappin Brothers have a beauty college in the Valley.
Yes.
And they help you get another job in sort of Hollywood.
Yes. I was introduced to hairdressing when I modeled for someone who was friends with the Lappin Brothers. And so I was fascinated with the whole fact you could go somewhere and learn how to do your hair. I was just like winging it all the time, trying to look like the Hollywood High School Deltas.
And that begins the career of Carrie White, who is a star in the Hollywood, really, Walk of Fame for hairdressing.
Thank you. I did trailblaze the field for women, I must say that. You know, there were a lot of great hairdressers in front of me, but I was the first woman to be acknowledged. In fact, Connie, the cutest thing in the world for me in my life was that I got this telegram to be on to tell the truth. Will the real Carrie White please stand up, when it was a show I'd watched all my life. And I thought, really, me? But I was 21, and I was serving champagne, and I had celebrities, and the word spread to New York. So.
And you also became, I would say, hairdresser to men as well as to Mrs. So-and-so, Mrs. So-and-so, Mrs. Head of the Studio.
Yes, that was exciting. And that I had a goal with because of Jay Sebring, who was a hairdresser who cut men's hair, unlike going to the barber and having, you know, one of three haircuts, a flat top, a greased back, or a buzz. And he was styling Steve McQueen and Paul Newman and all these, you know, handsome men, and Kirk Douglas. And I thought, oh, well, why can't I cut hair? Why can't I do men as well? And so I started getting the misters from the Mrs. Ups. And
tell me about Elvis Presley.
That was the exciting one. That was the exciting Mrs. when she said, my husband, Priscilla Presley, would like you to cut his hair. And I tried to be calm, and like, oh, let me see if I can work this out. Yes, I would be delighted.
And what happened when you did?